Here you can see the declaration of the scanner. Here we're reading an integer. Here we're reading a decimal number. And before we read anything, we have a prompt. One prompt for the age, one prompt for the weight. Finally, there is an important piece that you've not seen so far. Look up here. This is what's called an import statement. As it happens, the scanner class is in a different location than the classes that you've used so far. That location is called java.util. It's a utility class. And we have to tell the compiler that's the place to find it. Whenever you use the scanner, simply place this statement at the top of your code. Let's go ahead and run this. The console window pops up. Here is my prompt. Okay, I'm going to lie about my age here. Now, if that had been my age, of course, the program would be right. Next year, I'd be 22. Not much one can do about one's age. It does increase every year. I'm going to lie about my weight, too. But I appreciate the sentiment that hopefully next year, it'll be less. That at least should be under my control. All right, now you've seen how to read input, and I'd like you to do it in another program. Remember this program in which we added a sunset effect to a photo? Now here, we used a value of 25 to increase the redness. It might be nice to experiment with other numbers, but instead of recompiling the program with all sorts of different numbers, let's turn this one into a user input. Now we can't put the input statement here because this method is called for every single pixel and we only want to supply the input once. So here's the plan. Take out this constant and add a parameter here. Then here in the main method, prompt and read the input here before entering this piece of code. By the way, don't worry about this loop statement here. We're going to be covering that in a couple of lessons. Now here is the place that the method is called. That's where you should pass the added red variable so that each time the redden method adds that amount of red. Go ahead and do that now if you have BlueJ. It would be best if you first develop the program in BlueJ, and then when you're done, put your result into the Udacity IDE. If you don't have BlueJ, that's okay. Just do it straight in the IDE, but then you won't be able to supply your own input. You'll have to live with the input that Udacity gives you.